Well, we're going to be working now on repainting the black stuff here. A lot of methods to do it that work. The one that I'm going to do is to use a black Sharpie, mainly due to the absolute precision of the lay of the black material. I could use black paint, but this is black paint. It's just a little bit different. I'll bring you in. You can see. Yes, it's been redone, and the rest of it is not. It's a clean paint. You can see also how nicely the strings polished up just by using the jeweler's cloth. They used to look like that. Now they look like that, sparkly. I could use paint, but... I prefer this due to the precision of the dropping down of that stuff. Support your hand while you're doing it. Already had been painted. I'm gonna have to clean that one out. Somebody who repainted hit it with a little too much right here. Let's come up and get that a little bit. So you can see one advantage of this is you make a mistake, you can, it's a little bit too wet. Right now. Requires a very steady hand to do this and a feel for shape. This piano's been worked on many times. I can see that the gold has been repainted, and then they came in and again, I do like that I can get in and undo. This will come off for a while after it's put on. Okay. Not bad. I can give you a better angle over here. But a lot of times when you're working on old stuff, you know, you're going to be... Let's do the 1870. That might be interesting. This was the patent year, not the year. manufacturer. This is done, of course, with magnifying glasses. Too heavy. Would be much more difficult for me to go in and get the paint out if I didn't like the shaping, if I used regular paint. Close. All right. Go with that. I have to free draw some of this because the stamping's rather fat. And yet the letters need to look like letters, not like fat blobs of metal. So this is one of those instances where you have some creative control. Come back here. Looks pretty good compared to that. I think it's more accurately done than I could do with paint.